Cortisol is that steroid hormone that is produced by your two adrenal glands, which sit on top of each kidney. When you are stressed, cortisol is released into your bloodstream, but having the right cortisol balance is essential for your health, and producing too much or too little cortisol can cause health problems. In this video, we will look at five signs of your body having higher than average cortisol. So without further ado, real quick before we get started, hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and let's get started. First off, everyone has high cortisol from time to time, and levels vary throughout the day. It's part of your body's natural response to threats of harm or danger. But if your body consistently makes too much cortisol, that's when something could be potentially off. Because it's the adrenal glands that make the hormone, but the hypothalamus pituitary adrenal axis that controls how much your body releases. And when it does get released, most of the cells in your body have cortisol receptors to take in the cortisol and do important tasks with it, like control blood sugar, reduce inflammation, regulate your metabolism. It can even help form memories. And really, the only way to validate if your cortisol levels are in fact higher than normal is to get them checked, either with blood, urine, or saliva. And yes, it's normal that it peaks in the early morning and declines throughout the day, reaching its lowest level around midnight. Sometimes if you work a night shift and sleep at different times of the day, this can change too, but the normal levels, let's say from 6 a.m. to 8 a.m. are about 10 to 20 micrograms per deciliter and around 3 to 10 micrograms per deciliter closer to 4 p.m. But there are some clues that we could use to help us determine if it's indeed high, starting with the first being weight gain, especially in your face and abdomens. This is known as the moon face, where the face becomes more round, full, or puffy. The sides of the face you can see become so round from the buildup of fat that the ears can't be seen from the front. Also, you get the fat depositing over the sides of the skull too, which adds to the face looking more rounder. This is often but not always tied back to Cushing's syndrome, which comes with an array of its own symptoms. One hallmark is the pink or purple stretch marks on the stomach, hips, thighs, breasts, and underarms. The second symptom, though, is excessive hair growth in females, otherwise known as hirsutism, which affects about 10% of women in the US. Having chronically high cortisol is not the only cause of hirsutism, though. We know that conditions like PCOS, acromegaly, and sometimes pregnancy can cause this to occur as well. You may have even experienced it by trying minoxidil too, which does go away once you stop, which is also good to know. The third symptom of high cortisol is what's called the buffalo hump. This may be more of a direct association with Cushing's syndrome, though, where you get the fat production that often gets deposited in the neck, which is known as lipodystrophy. Hopefully, if you've experienced this, you have already discussed with your endocrinologist a plan to treat it at this stage. Just FYI. A fourth symptom of high cortisol is just having weak bones, which can lead to osteoporosis and sometimes fractures. This is because elevated cortisol levels interfere with osteoblast formation and decreases bone building, which then reduces bone density. Basically, more bone tissue is broken down than it is deposited. And lastly, easy bruising. Now, this isn't only indicative of high cortisol. Chemotherapy, blood thinners, and aging are also some examples where bruising easily can occur. But the way in which cortisol causes it is how it breaks down some of the dermal proteins and how it weakens the small blood vessels. In fact, sometimes the skin may become so weak it develops this shiny, paper-thin quality, which allows it to be torn easily too. This is an issue because it increases the chances of skin infections, which is something we don't want. And remember, there can be more symptoms than just these five. A few others can be elevated blood sugar, high blood pressure, and mood swings. Many conditions share these similar symptoms, which is why if you suspect any of these, it's important to discuss them with your primary care doctor to find the right treatment plan that is tailored for you and get a proper diagnosis. In the meantime, though, a few tips that you can take to help manage cortisol, be it that you have been diagnosed with Cushing's syndrome, adrenal gland tumor, or corticosteroids, or let's say none of those, and you feel like your cortisol is always just elevated, yes, speak to your doctor, but also start by changing up some lifestyle measures that you can start implementing today, like getting quality sleep, which is in fact treating conditions like sleep apnea or insomnia that affect this, exercising regularly, combating stressful thinking patterns, practicing deep breathing exercises, and a current favorite of mine, which is Shinrin Yoku, which is forest bathing, since we have some evidence that people who practice forest bathing, their salivary cortisol levels were significantly lower in the forest groups compared with the urban groups, and how overall forest bathing can significantly influence cortisol levels on a short term in such a way. Also guys, if you're in the clear to try supplements by your doctor, adaptogens can be a great starting point. Two of my favorite ones are ashwagandha, which we talked about a lot on this channel. Studies show us that a high concentration full spectrum ashwagandha root extract safely and effectively improves an individual's resistance towards stress and thereby improves self-assessed quality of life. Secondly, Rhodiola Rosea, which extracts show us an anti-fatigue effect that increases mental performance, particularly the ability to concentrate, and decreases cortisol response to awakening stress in burnout patients with fatigue syndrome. Both of which I link down below in the description that you could check out, as well as videos discussing them in more detail for you down there as well. I'm more curious to actually hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts on this? Let me know in the comments below. Also, hit that subscribe button too if you found any value in this, and I'll see you on the next one.